18 long months, a chance to turn the page on a disappointing last year. To open the new digs, the defending national champs, Gino Auriemma's UConn Huskies are college basketball's best. A new season, a new home, the national champs. What are we waiting for? Let's go! Downtown Seattle is all dressed up, and boy, do they have a place to go tonight. Just a few months ago, this was Heck Edmondson Pavilion. And tonight, it is christened Bank America Arena. And tonight, a great way to christen it, in what is, believe me, a 10,000-seat basketball arena that has touches of the old, touches of the new. It is the new home of the Washington Huskies, the number one team in the country, UConn, against Washington. Hi, everyone. Rich Waltz along with Elise Woodward. As a former player, you have to be pretty proud of this new place.
Well, I tell you, when I was getting recruited in 1992, they promised me, when you're a junior, this place will be all finished. They showed me the plans. It's finally done. I'm jealous I missed it, but I'm very excited for the rest of the program, for the men's and women's team to get this building. It's beautiful.
And to open it, not only the best team in the country last year, the national champs, the best team in the country this year, some are saying the best team ever. The UConn Huskies have not one, but two All-Americans in their starting lineup. Svetlana Abrosimova and Shea Ralph are two of the best players we've seen in a long time.
Well, first team All-American, that about sums them up. They both are very versatile. They're over 6 feet. They're guards. Svetlana is a forward, but she can move the basketball. They both have a point guard's vision. Watch out when these two get the ball, because they will pass quick all over the place. You never know what to expect, and they can score.
If Washington is to stay in this ball game, they must shoot the ball well, and I think that falls on the shoulders of Megan Franza.
Well, especially now that their leading scorer from last year, Lori Payne, is out with a stress fracture in her foot. Megan Franza is really going to have to step up. She is the scorer for the Washington Huskies. She is going to be counted on from the three-point range all the way down. She's a good penetrator, but she's the one that the Huskies, the UConn Huskies, are going to have to concentrate on stopping.
It is a brand new building. We'll be showing it off all night. And oh, by the way, maybe the best team ever in women's college basketball. It's UConn. It's Washington. It's a very special night on Montlake. And they'll tip it off when we get back.
This, it's death-defying, car-crashing, fist-flying action. You gotta see this Sunday at 6 on Fox Sports Net.
You can see a brand new roof. They took a lot of the old roofing out. You've got steel girders and windows and all kinds of nooks and crannies. Just a great place, it looks like, and we'll see how it plays tonight. Bank of America Arena, here's your starting lineups. UConn on the left, you should recognize these names. Shea Ralph, Sue Bird, Svetlana Abrosimova, Swin Cash, as well as Asia Jones. For Washington, Kelly O'Neill, Leanne Sheets, Emily Autry, Megan Franza, Giolana Mendiola. There he is, Gino Auriemma, Coach of the Year last year, a pair of national championships, 7 consecutive Big East titles. June Doherty in her fifth year, trying to bounce back from last year's 8-22 season. And the UConn Huskies, the number one team in the country, wins the tip. And this is Asia Jones with the first shot, and she misses. Washington controls. Mendiola getting the start, the true freshman point guard, going up against the best point guard in the country. And that's a matchup to watch early on. This is Mendiola with the ball, and she's guarded by Sue Bird. Rebound kicks out to Emily Autry. And a foul. Wesley Dean, Judy Stroud, Mark Zents, the trio of officials. Shea Ralph with their first personal. What type of pace are we going to see here tonight?
Well, if the UConn Huskies, you want it fast-paced. They move the ball up and down the floor, and they have so much depth, they don't worry about getting tired. The Washington Huskies have to slow it down.
Sheets couldn't control, and she gets it back. UConn very good in transition. Bird hits the layup, and UConn has a 2-0 lead.
The ball in Sue Bird's hands in the fast break. She is so aware of her court. She knows right there the 2-on-1 situation. She has a man open. She takes it all the way. Don't worry about a pass if you don't have to.
This is Leanne Sheets off to Franza. Mendiola, who's earned the start tonight after two very impressive games against Big Ten teams. And Kelly O'Neal hits a turnaround. Washington and UConn tied at two.
Well, Kelly O'Neal last year struggled mightily with an ankle injury, and she just never was herself after the injury about eight games in the season.
And there's the All-America, the two-time All-American, Svetlana Abrosimova, with the jump hook in the lane. They cannot afford, Washington cannot afford to let her get the ball in the low blocks like that. O'Neal, the baseline drive. Missed the cripple. And a rare UConn turnover. UConn does not turn the ball over much at all. They are plus seven in turnovers. That means their opponents cough it up seven more times per game. Here's a look at Abrosimova, and one of the best coaches in college basketball, period, men or women.
Well, the one thing that Gino Auriemma stresses is no turnovers. He wants his team to fast break. He does not want careless turnovers. That's his number one priority. That's what he constantly harps on his team for. Take care of the basketball.
Washington 1-1 this year with an overtime loss at Indiana and a big win on the road at Michigan has turned it over a whole bunch. Drive by Asia Jones. And Asia Jones will go to the line. And Washington is turning it over eight times per game, more than their opponents. And that is a mixture, a dangerous one, early on against UConn.
Well, the one thing that June Doherty expressed that they must do is take care of the basketball. UConn pressures defense. They're worried a little bit about the full court pressure because, for one reason, they're starting a freshman point guard, Juliana Mendiola. She's a great ball handler, but she is a freshman, and there's a little bit of an intimidation factor when you're facing the number one team in the nation.
Asia Jones hits them both. UConn with a 6-2 lead, and here's the full court pressure that Washington expected, and Sue Bird with a reach in backcourt. And Bird again. Little double team in backcourt. Washington handles it nicely.
You can see how Connecticut is taking Washington out of their rhythm, though. They're not sure offensively what to do with that trap.
No shot clock reset, and Shea Ralph couldn't save the ball. Washington has it, and this trapping defense giving the Huskies some problems here. No trap here, but shot clock at a dozen. And another Washington turnover.
That's the kind of mistakes they cannot afford to make against this UConn team. UConn capitalizes. They use every possession. Washington has to take care of the basketball, move the ball around, make Connecticut play defense.
Washington forces a turnover. Emily Autry. Franza, a three. UConn right back to work. Sue Bird. Kicked away. And UConn with a couple of turnovers on their last two possessions. That's good news for Washington.
They're trying to get out and push the ball, but right now they're trying to make the great pass and just taking this instead of just taking the solid one.
A bomb from O'Neal.
That's one thing that Kelly O'Neal can do, make the Connecticut big defenders come out. Kelly O'Neal is playing the four, clear Connecticut out of the paint, make them guard her on the three-point arc.
Abrosimova, she is good from anywhere on the floor.
Deadly.
At 6'2", she can play inside, she can play outside. She was a member of the Russian Olympic team this past season. An offensive foul on Washington. Autry with the drive. She'll pick up her first personal.
Well, I think one thing that people think of Connecticut, they think of a powerhouse offensive team, but defense is where they lay their foundation. Last year, they led the nation, holding opponents to just 34% shooting from the field.
Backdoor, Abrosimova wide open. And Svetlana now with 7 points. UConn has their biggest lead by six.
That's just a great read by Shea Ralph. Keeps her eyes up, sees the wide open Abrosimova cutting down the lane.
Franza, they need her to hit a few of those if Washington is to stay close. O'Neal wide open.
Great look work inside by Mendiola. She got the loose ball. She kept her eyes up. She sees O'Neal underneath the hoop. Good job, O'Neal, not getting nervous. Wide open like that, she put it in.
Asia Jones, turnaround.
That is an unstoppable shot. If you got somebody 6'2" that can step out, turn with a fadeaway jumper, that's tough. You just put a hand in your face and hope.
She stays inbound, so Abrosimova. Washington needs a timeout and will take one. 9 points in 5 minutes of play from the two-time All-America, Svetlana Abrosimova. And UConn is up 15-7 in Bank of America Arena.
Nothing says I love you more than a dazzling diamond from International Jewelers.
Right now, take advantage of 6 month same as cash financing at International Jewelers. Near the mall, not nearly the price. South Center, Tacoma, Bellevue, Alderwood. Take the time to cross the street to International Jewelers.
Discussing a man's sexual behavior is always a very discreet topic. This commercial talks about NRX, a safe, natural alternative to prescription drugs when you want that extra burst of sexual energy.
Are you one of the millions of American males who would like increased sexual energy when you need it most? NRX is the answer.
Clinical studies show various ingredients of NRX to enhance sexual energy and performance when taken on a regular basis.
You'll enjoy your newfound energy the natural way, without chemicals. We're so sure you and your mate will be completely satisfied, we'll offer you a 30-day, no questions asked, full refund.
But now, it's like about incredible every single day.
It's great.
Call now and take advantage of our special television offer.
Call 1-800-283-2850 and order NRX now. Forget those expensive pills and chemicals. Get results using the safe, effective, all-natural alternative, NRX.
And offensively, Svetlana Abrosimova is dominating right now.
You just see her reading the passing lane right there. The freshman, Mendiola, careless with the basketball. Svetlana's seen that before. She stepped right in the lane, goes all the way down for the easy bucket.
Points in the paint, and the scary thing is UConn is playing without their big kid, Kelly Schumacher, the 6'5 senior out of Quebec, injured, not in the ball game. Cheryl Sorensen into the game, and she misses from in close for Washington. June Doherty off that timeout, bringing Sorensen, the sophomore out of Milwaukee, Oregon. And there's the backdoor cut, and Abrosimova's got 11 now.
That right there is what's scary about Connecticut, is that they execute offensively. They time their cuts. They read what's going on. They take what the defense gives them, and that's why they are so effective in half-court sets.
Washington handles the press nicely. Franza has missed all three of her shots, and she fouls Asia Jones in open court. Timeout on the floor. UConn 17, Washington 7. We'll return to Bank of America Arena after this.
Fox Sports Net.
Just about a full house tonight to open this new building, relatively speaking. $40 million they poured into Peck Ed Pavilion. It was closed for 19 months, and it opens tonight with the number one team in women's college basketball in town. Diana Taurasi is in, and she feeds Asia Jones.
You see Washington switched into a 2-3 zone. They're getting beat back door with a nice cut, so now they're trying to clog the paint by switching to a 2-3 zone.
Jill Pimley and Sarah Duncan have come into the Washington backcourt. This is Duncan. Feeds O'Neal. Kelly O'Neal has all 9 of Washington's points.
She's feeling it tonight. She's playing well, and she's playing composed.
Into the corner. This is Taurasi, the number one high school player in America last year, and she doesn't even start on this team.
But that is the depth of Connecticut. They have All-Americans sitting, lining across their bench. It's a matter of how can you get playing time for all these players. That's Gino Williams' challenge more than, you know, how to beat other teams, is how to keep his team happy.
Everyone returning from last year's national championship team, a team that went 36-1
And believe me, they are all thinking about that one loss. It was against Tennessee by just 1 point.
Penley shot blocked by Jones, and here come the UConn Huskies. Sue Bird, backdoor, Abrojimova. She has 13 points. And UConn stretches their lead to 12. And you know what? UConn is not playing that well. And that's the scary thing right now. Abrojimova with the steal. They turned it over three times in the first 4 minutes of play, which is rare for these guys. And count that one. Tamika Williams with the bucket.
The thing that sticks out about Connecticut is their unselfishness. There's not one player on this team that led the nation in scoring, that concentrates on her stats. It's a very balanced team with five players in double figures. You see here, they do it with defense. Abrosimova running end to end. She scores on one end. She makes it all the way down to the baseline on the other end. And then the beautiful passing down underneath. Washington does not get back in time, does not get in position, and Connecticut capitalizes.
Sarah Duncan with the foul, and Tamika Williams with a three-point play. And here's the pressure.
Connecticut will keep coming after you. So far, the refs calling it pretty tight in the backcourt. They've picked up two hand check fouls on Connecticut. And that's bailed the Huskies out of it. You don't want to catch the ball in the press down below free throw line extended. It leaves the other team easily to trap.
Abrojimova is a senior. Ralph is a senior. And both consensus All-American, and both will be first-round WNBA picks. Washington up the floor. Melissa Erickson in the ballgame now. Franza. UConn will be in man-to-man pressure throughout the night. Mendiola's back in. Juliana. And this is Erickson with a nice head fake, but she missed the jumper. Release the hounds. Here come UConn Huskies. Washington will burn a timeout. Washington has burned two timeouts in the seconds before natural timeouts on the floor. That was a necessity to keep the possession. June Doherty called a timeout moments before a media timeout would have come on the next whistle. And so Washington burns a couple of timeouts.
Well, when you're down right now 24-9, the timeout just called is not a bad timeout by Melissa Erickson. The ball was on the ground. It's a good job. Realizing that Jill Pimley is on the ground with the ball, going to the ref and saying timeout, keeping the possession instead of a travel. But at this point, 24-9, when you were down in that margin, you have to do something to stop the momentum. Anything to get UConn to settle down, to stop their momentum, just keep their speed down and not get on a roll.
Washington 4 of 14 from the floor. UConn has only missed twice. And a lot of those shots have been layups. Erickson with the ball, and Swin Cash picks up her first personal foul. There's that media timeout we told you about. UConn 24, Washington 9. We'll return to Seattle after this. For just about everybody, in case you know somebody high up, this is your first peek at this facility. Bank of America Arena. They still call it Heck Edmondson Pavilion. And it opened back in 1927 is when they built this place for $600,000. And another UConn steal. And another UConn, well, no, not that time. Abrojimova with the foul. On the rebound, she was over the back of Andrea Lollum. There's a look at Lollum. June Doherty goes deep into her bench. Now, Washington is playing without one of their top scorers, Lori Payne, 17 points a game. UConn is playing without their big kid, the 6'5 Kelly Schumacher, A steal and a foul, all them fouling Swin Cash.
What's kind of ironic about both of those girls being out is that Kelly Schumacher and Lori Payne played together this summer with Sue Bird and Shea Ralph in the Jones Cup Championships in Taiwan. Stress fractures are brought on by over usage, and they played all summer long for the United States, and now they're both sitting during their season with stress fractures on the bench, and I'm sure they're very disappointed. It's just kind of ironic that both played with another now when they were so excited to play against each other. I know Lori Payne especially, and now they're not able to.
Swin Cash makes one of two. UConn gets the rebound. There's the putback, and it's good. So Cash essentially gets a three-point play. And UConn's lead is now 27-9. Mendiola. This is Jill Pimley. Franza into the lane. And Megan Franza gets one to drop. Washington's leading score, 19 points a game.
But when there's pressure defense like UConn is doing right now, you have to take it to them. You have to penetrate the gaps. If they're overplaying, you have to go to the basket.
Washington foul. Giuliana Mendiola. Look at Mendiola. She was the Orange County Player of the Year last year. True freshman.
And her career scoring average in high school, unbelievable. 27 points per game in high school.
She had five games in her career over 50 points. And she played in a very good league as well. Abrozimova to Cash. Enough said. Five now for Swin Cash. It's an 18-point lead. Mendiola's in trouble. Pimley in the double team. It's a held ball. No, it's a foul.
Washington has to quit inbounding the ball to somebody so far deep in the corner. Got to get it out. It's the easiest trap in the world when you inbound it 3 feet from the baseline out of bounds. It leaves the person on the ball 3 feet to travel. It's an automatic trap, and you're stuck. There's nowhere to release the ball to. They've got to inbounds it past free throw line extended. Put the pressure on the defense.
Speaking of pressure, nine Washington turnovers. 9.5 minutes into the ball game. Franz's fouls. And she headed up that sideline. Back into the ball game is Sue Bird. And Franza goes to the line. Washington is obviously hoping that Lori Payne makes it back before Pac-10 play starts. She makes a nice compliment to Franza, who misses the front end of 1-1. Spin move by Cash, and she's fouled.
Connecticut, you can see the spacing. They don't usually put somebody in the low block, and that leaves the rest of the court open. It's a 1-4 high set. Cash just goes into the lane. She uses the opening. She gets position, and then she just goes up. She knows she's going to get fouled, or she's going to have a wide open two. That's Connecticut executing their half-court offense. And you can tell how much time Gino Auriemma and their staff put into the practices. You can see that's what they work on, their half-court sets, among other things that they do so extraordinarily well. But it's beautiful to watch them work in the half-court set. They move without the basketball. They cut to the open spaces. They do everything a coach wants their team to do, and that's why they're so successful.
Cash hits one of two. Full-court pressure, and the freshman Mendiola gives it up to Pimley. Into the lane. Nice dish. Nice finish. But she walked beforehand. Leanne Sheets traveled. Washington turnover number 10.
At least they're putting the pressure on the defense. Jill Pimley took it to the defense, was aggressive, and that's what they have to do.
This is Shea Ralph, who gets a rather large moving screen from Swin Cash. Cash will pick up the foul. UConn this year on this Western swing won at Pepperdine the other night quite handily, 98-63. UConn opened their season against the number three team in the country. Gino Auriemma's team beat Georgia by 29, 99-70.
Well, 99 points. That is, in 40 minutes, 99 points. That's an amazing number. And that's why this team, why so many people so early in this season are saying this could be the best team ever. That's the third-ranked team in the nation, Georgia. A great team with the twins, Kelly and Coco Miller, Tawana McDonald, an excellent team with depth. The third-ranked team in the nation, they blew them out by 29 points. And that's the potential of this Connecticut team.
Ralph thought about three. In the lane, draws contact. She'll get free throws. Leanne Sheets with the foul.
It was good help by Sheets coming off her person, seeing Ralph drive down the lane, but she did not get her feet set. You saw her sideways. Ralph took the contact. She's one of the best in the nation, drawing the contact. She gets to the line, and she shoots 88% from the line.
Shea Ralph, first team All-American, Final Four MVP last year. And she drops in a pair, and UConn stretches their lead now, their biggest of the ball game, to 21, or rather to 19. Still their biggest of the ball game.
Quick math, gotta be good at it.
I know, I'm not. Baseline jumper is good from Kelly O'Neal, who has 11 of Washington's 15. Bob pass in low to Mika Williams finishes.
And they're so effective again, just spreading the Husky, the Washington Husky defense out and leaving the lane wide open.
Abrosimova. O'Neal. Bang!
She's on fire. She's feeling good today, and that's nice to see for her coming off a year last year when she was injured. You can see in her face she's determined. She's from her hometown. She has a lot of family here to watch her. Her little sister actually is going to play for the Huskies next year. She just signed a letter of intent, so I'm sure she's fired up in the stands as well.
And her sister Kristen out of Linwood. Bird the miss. Abrosimova. 15 now for Abrosimova.
She has not yet missed a shot.
She's pretty good, huh?
Just a little bit.
Franza against Ralph. Loose ball. Bird. Ralph.
That right there, it speaks of the unselfishness of this Connecticut team. It's a three-on-one. Bird lifts her eyes up. She sees two wide-open teammates down low, and then the nice dish to Ralph. Either one could have shot the lane, and it's a nice, it's just an assist, unselfish play right there.
Asia Jones gets the assist, and Ralph now with 4 points and a whistle in low. UConn draws an offensive foul, I think from Leanne Sheets. Second personal on Sheets, and she will sit down. Melissa Erickson is back in.
You see Sue Bird in the open breaks. There's nobody in basketball this year that does it better in the open court than Sue Bird. A nice look upfield to Asia Jones, and she sees her teammate. She sees Shea Ralph right underneath, hands it off with the easy two. And that right there is why Shea Ralph is shooting over 80% from the field so far this season. As a guard last year, she shot 62% from the field. Those are unbelievable numbers for a guard.
As a team, UConn is shooting 57% on the season.
Well, that's one of the numerous categories they led the nation in last year. They just execute so well, and they get wide open shots underneath the hoop, and those are easy to make.
Shea Ralph running over Melissa Erickson. And Erickson goes to the line. Gino Auriemma still coaching him up. You know, UConn has been the number one team in the country for as long as it has taken to renovate this building. Erickson drops in a free throw. Took them 19 months to renovate this building. UConn was the preseason number one last year, held on to number one throughout the season, won the national championship, is the preseason number one this year.
Well, the interesting thing to see is that they're going to be able to run the table this year and stay number one ranked the entire season. Only one other team in history has done that, and that's Louisiana Tech in 80-82, and that's quite an accomplishment.
And they look pretty darn good tonight. The UConn Huskies on top of the Washington Huskies. Opening night, the Bank of America Arena. It's a 19-point ball game. UConn on top of Washington. 7:40 left in the first half. Svetlana Abrosimova, showing why she's a two-time first-team All-American tonight.
Well, you can see her there. She knows how to read the defense. She's obviously from Russia, and the style of the European player is to move without the basketball, and she does that so well. And that's why you see her moving in the half court often. She just reads and lurks and just waits for that opening, and her teammates can find her.
UConn turnover. Asia Jones with the offensive foul. 7.5 minutes left, first half. Washington turned it over a lot early, and they've settled down a little bit right now.
Well, I'm sure they're breathing a sigh of relief because UConn has called off the press for now.
Sorensen in the double team. It's ripped away by Tamika Williams. And here comes that UConn break. Taurasi. She is a player, as Frank Broyles used to say.
When you're the National Player of the Year and she joins two others on the Connecticut team, and Shea Ralph and Tamika Williams, this team is just stocked with talent. It's almost unfair.
The haves and the have-nots in women's college basketball, there's a huge, huge, I think, valley between Gene Auriemma's UConn Huskies, Pat Summit's Tennessee Volunteers, Georgia, some of the strong teams in the SEC, the Big Ten, the Big East, and the, you know, you get down to the 10 through 20 teams in college basketball. It's a huge, huge difference.
It has gotten progressively better. This year, this Connecticut team is an anomaly because they are so good. They're better, like we've talked about, they might be the best team ever. They have that kind of potential. When you look at the rest of the teams in the top 10, they're good, but they do not come close to this team.
Turn around, and a nice one from Asia Jones.
But I don't think that's necessarily bad for women's basketball to have a team so dominant. It makes everybody raise their level. It pushes the bar. This is what you have to be. I mean, this is the best that's out there.
Franza with some fancy dribbling, but she missed the shot. Well, it's not like UConn is dominated in terms of national championships. They've won two, 95, and then last year, and of course Tennessee has had their share. So by no means is this a UCLA of the 60s and 70s run. But right now, in the present day, UConn is it. 43-20. I asked Gino Auriemma, I said, how do you deal with the label, maybe the best team ever? And he said, you know what? The people that are calling us the best teams ever are our opponents, our other coaches, because they want to make that target on our backs even bigger. He said, it's unfair to call a team the best team ever until the season's complete, because we haven't done anything yet.
Well, they haven't done anything except for return all five starters from last year's national championship and drill the third-ranked team in the nation. I mean, there's a good argument right there, but I understand his point. He wants his team to concentrate on what lies ahead rather than, you know, all these labels of what could be.
Sue Bird, and a 15-footer won't go. Giolana Mendiola, the young freshman, getting the start at the point tonight for Washington. Cheryl Sorensen in trouble in the corner. Franza O'Neill. That was nice. 16 now for O'Neill.
And she just has a nice touch from around the basket. She's expanded her range. We saw her step out a moment ago for the long jumper. She's got an all-around game that she's developing. It's nice to see her improvement.
O'Neal again. Count it. 18 for O'Neal.
And this is definitely her best game by far in her collegiate career. Last year, she was solid the beginning of the season. And I mentioned earlier, she had an ankle injury, and she never was quite the same. You see her out boxing out. She does the good box out. Gets it to Mendiola, and then O'Neal flies down the floor. She's got good speed for her size. She's 6'1", and then strong, goes up, uses the backboard, and gets the hack, and she'll go to the line, and she's feeling it right now.
There you see her, 18 points. 19 now.
And just a sophomore.
And she's one of the reasons why a lot of people feel Washington will bounce back. Maybe not in a huge way, but in a big way this year in the Pac-10 standings. A disappointing 4-14. They were ninth in the Pac-10 last year. But they have the two sophomores in Autry and O'Neal. Actually, three sophomores if Lori Payne can return to the lineup with her injury.
Well, they have a good sophomore class.
Abrojimova.
She's always around the basketball. She has a nose for the ball. She knows where to move to get the ball. She's in the right place at the right time. It's one of those things you can't teach those kind of skills.
17 points for Abrojimova. Sarah Duncan. In low to Lalum. O'Neal taken away. Tarasi to Bird. To Tarasi with the left hand, and she'll get free throw.
When you start out in basketball, there's one drill the coaches always make you do, and it's the two-man passing drill, and you go up and down the floor with, you know, bounce passes, or, and this is exactly what Sue Bird and Tarasi do down the floor. Back to you. No, back to you. No, you take it. You take it. And then finally Tarasi with the left hand, she almost gets to go, but she does get the foul. Just a good job moving with the basketball on the open floor. And Tarasi is smooth. She's got a nice outside jumper, and she's just got a good feel for the basketball. You can see she's put a lot of time in the gym.
Mendiola fouls. There's a look at Tarasi. You know, when she was in high school, she had a rival across town who's going to the free throw line right now, and Juliana Mendiola. Mendiola was the Orange County Player of the Year. Tarasi didn't win that award, but Tarasi was named National Player of the Year. They played on the same AAU team. They were high school rivals, and they meet here tonight. Both a long way from home.
A long way from home, but I tell you, those two have a long future in front of them with basketball. Both of them can score the basketball, just flat out put the ball in the hole. You know, both of them career averages in 26, 28 points per game in high school.
Washington misses four shots and then fouls Abrojimova. Washington getting some pretty good shots right now, but it's June Doherty talked earlier this afternoon about two things that worried her. Number one is opening the new building because there's a lot of butterflies. There's a big crowd. She wasn't sure how her team would react. The other thing is you're playing UConn, a team that not only is number one in the country, but for her players, a team that they've seen on national TV. They watched them in the Final Four last year. Gino Auriemma is an icon in women's college basketball.
Well, if you were ever going to have butterflies or ever have a game where you have so much adrenaline you almost feel sick, it would be this one. For the Huskies opening this brand new arena, they've waited forever to get in here. They had to move all the way off campus last year. So excited to get back home where they don't have to bus to their own home games. And then the chance to play the very best that's offered in college basketball at your home to open the arena. I mean, those two emotions, you could see them jumping before the game, just the adrenaline pumping through their veins.
Kenitra Johnson's checked into the ball game. Duncan in some trouble. Franza missed the three. She's had a rough night. Fans thought that Johnson walked.
Now watch UConn, they will spread the floor. They will not have a low post presence. You see right now, they're all just gonna move without the basketball.
Okay. Morgan Valley back to Johnson. Nice block from behind. I think Duncan may have gotten it. Franza. Lalum. Valley with the rebound. Brozhimova and UConn, a 48-26 lead. UConn with that patented 1-4 set. Johnson, a baseline drive by Franza. Offensive foul. Yep. It'll come the other way. Kenitra Johnson, the freshman, with an offensive foul. UConn, number one in the country. Someone forgot to tell Kelly O'Neill. 19 so far for O'Neill. You can see the windows now here at Heck Edmondson Pavilion, now Bank of America Arena, when they took off that false roof that was...
That's my favorite part.
Yeah.
I love it.
That's a little Allen Fieldhouse for you in Kansas. This is a little Allen Fieldhouse, a little Cameron Indoor, a little Williams Arena, all mixed in at halftime. We hope you're with us. Barbara Hedges is the athletic director of Washington. We'll talk about opening night here. Some highlights, and at least we'll tell you how good UConn is. And then we'll have a studio update as well.
I think they're proving it already.
Duncan throws it away. Abrozhimova. Ashley Battle is in the ball game for the Huskies, along with Tamika Williams. UConn not only very good, but very, very deep. This is Shea Ralph.
Ashley Battle, a freshman who actually played for Oriema this summer on one of the USA junior national teams. Her and Taurasi played for Oriema, so they were already ingrained in the system. And it just shows you the depth. She's just getting into the ball game. She was an All-American last year in high school.
Abrozhimova, Lalum got a hand on it. No shot clock reset, 16 left on that one.
You see Abrozhimova and Shea Ralph nodding at each other, though, like, I see you, I see you. They look for each other on the floor. They've got a special connection. They've played together now for 4 years, and they definitely look for each other on the floor.
O'Neal's back in the ball game. There is an over and back in women's college basketball. Ralph, it's the three. 7 points for Shea Ralph.
And she's been kind of quiet tonight for her, just steady doing her job. And Abrozhimova is the one that's been going off. She's got 19 already.
Franza loads and fires. It has been a long night, or a long first half, for Megan Franza. Now 1 of 9, 0 of 5 from beyond the arc. A put back by Williams is good. She's got 7. UConn's biggest lead now at 53-26.
Well, that's been the tale of the game right there, is that Washington Huskies come down and fire a three with somebody with a hand in her face. Well, then on the other end, Connecticut goes down the easy wide open lane underneath, and that's why they're shooting over 70% from the field. UConn and the Huskies are shooting under 40. It's the difference in shots. It's Washington needs to take their time, work the Connecticut defense, make them work, as opposed to firing threes and first pass ball side, you know, throwing up a shot. Connecticut defense, you've got to put them on their heels and make them work.
One of the things I really like about women's college basketball is that the teams like UConn and Tennessee and Louisiana Tech play each other in the regular season. Tennessee and UConn obviously are in different conferences, the SEC and the Big East. But they will play a home and home this year.
And it's fun for the fans of women college basketball to see these two teams meet before the NCAA tournament. You can see, you know, how it's going to match up in the postseason and talk about who's better. And last year, that was the only loss of the Connecticut season was Tennessee. And they like it because it's not a blowout. They have somebody of their own caliber that they actually can play against. Where it comes down to the wire.
Emily Autry picked up that loose ball. Gioconda Mendiola is in the ball game now. So the Mendiola sisters get some playing time here. And a UConn steal, and here come the Huskies. Ashley Battle. Wide open is Bird. Battle finds Ralph, who can't hold it. And with 11 seconds left in this first half, UConn turns it over. Mendiola missed the three, Bird the rebound. Got to get it up. Abrozimova did not see the clock, and UConn's shot won't go. If there were any doubts that UConn was the number one team in the country, at least in our viewing audience, I think Gino Auriemma's Huskies eased those thoughts in a real hurry. 53-27, UConn on top of Washington. Stick around, a lot coming up at the half.
Hey, Keith, can you tell A.C. Green I'm ready when he is?
No.
The Keith Olbermann Evening News, Sundays at 10.
At Performance Nissan Kia, get a $500 Alderwood Mall gift certificate or make no payments for 6 months with any purchase, new or used. Performance Nissan Kia, we make it easy.
Net. You're watching Fox Sports Net.
The number one team in the country, UConn, on top of Washington, 53-27, as they have opened Bank of America Arena. It's halftime. Let's go back to our Fox Sports Net studios for this halftime update.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Fox Sports Studios for the halftime report. I'm Bill Wixie.
I'm Angie Arlotti. Well, there's good news for Seahawks fans. Sunday's game will be on television in the Seattle area. There are still about 1,000 tickets left for Sunday's game against the Broncos, but Cairo TV has guaranteed a sellout.
Well, the Mariners want to know where they stand in the A-Rod sweepstakes. They have a meeting scheduled with Alex Rodriguez next week. M's chief executive Howard Lincoln says he wants to make sure Alex is still interested in returning to Seattle.
And the University of Washington football team will know tomorrow if they will have a shot at the national championship. If Miami downs Boston College, the Huskies will be knocked out of the Orange Bowl.
Meanwhile, Arizona State, Dick Tomey resigns after this game. And the fourth, Tom Pace takes it in for the 3-yard touchdown, gives ASU a 10-point lead, and the Sun Devils go on to win it 30-17. Arizona State with lame duck head coach Bruce Snyder probably going bowling after all.
Colorado and Nebraska, Gary Barnett goes for two, down by one late in the fourth, and the gamble pays off. Craig Oaks drills it to Javon Green for the conversion, and Colorado is up by one with less than a minute left. But the game winner, it belongs to Nebraska. From 29 yards out, Josh Brown is right down the middle of the uprights. Huskers go on to win it 34-32.
All that and much, much more coming up tonight on the 11 p.m. Regional Sports Report. Be sure to join us for that.
Complete highlights of the Sonics and Clippers, and we'll hear from the players after the game. We'll see you then.
Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Angie. Look at this new place. Windows. They've got steel beams. It is a new look. Heck, Edmondson Pavilion. Bank of America Arena. When we get back, Washington Athletic Director Barbara Hedges will tell you about this new basketball arena. UConn up big at the half. Number one, UConn on top of Washington, 53-27. But the real story here is a brand new building for the University of Washington. Bank of America Arena is open for business. A $40 million facelift to Heck Edmondson Pavilion. Barbara Hedges, athletic director at Washington. You have to be very proud. This really is quite a building.
It is a great building. You know, we've restored an old building that was built in 1927. And it's been 8 years in getting it all done, and I'm absolutely thrilled.
I look around this arena. I see a little bit of Cameron Indoor at Duke. I see a little of Williams Arena in Minnesota. I see with the windows a little bit of Allen Fieldhouse. Those are all great traditional basketball arenas in college. Did you go out and look at those places before you remodeled this thing?
We actually did. I sent two people out about 8 years ago, and I asked them to look at five or six facilities, one of which was Cameron Indoor. I think we went to Kansas, University of Kansas, and we didn't look at the old field houses. And then we made a decision whether to build new or restore this building, and we decided we were going to restore the building.
The process of restoring this building, it's amazing to come in here, having not been in here during the restoration. Take taking the roof, the false roof off, I think was maybe the biggest, most ambitious deal, and taking the support beams out. There are no more seats where you can't, where you have to sit behind a beam.
Absolutely. We took out 18 columns. We didn't take the roof off, though. That's the great thing about this design. The design you see here, the truss design on both sides, is unique in the world. And it was designed by a firm in Seattle, which is world-renowned engineering firm. But it's a very unique system. So now every seat in the house is a great seat.
I'll bet the ribbon cutting was a lot of fun tonight.
It was great. Listen, I am absolutely fired up about tonight because we worked so hard and so many people have put so much into it, and so I'm absolutely thrilled. I'm thrilled for everybody.
College basketball fans, I have a feeling it's going to be a very special place. Congratulations. I look forward to a fun season and many seasons to come in this place.
Thank you very much.
All right, Barbara Hedges, athletic director here, University of Washington. Bank of America Arena is open for business. You can even see lights through those windows. We're back after this.
It was a little intimidating at first, a sophomore working with so many.
Watching Fox Sports Net.
53-27, halftime score, UConn on top of Washington. Rich Waltz, along with Elise Woodward, welcome back to Bank of America Arena. Highlights. UConn, lots of UConn in the highlights.
Well, I tell you, UConn, they're proving their point. They're the number one team. There you see the beautiful backdoor cut by Svetlana Abrosimova. She's got 19 points in the half, obviously leading the way for UConn. But the major one thing that UConn, they pressed the Huskies, forced them into turnovers. This might be the Huskies' best job all night of breaking that press. They move it all the way down. Jill Kimley with a nice pass, and then Sheets travels. It's kind of been the epitome for the Huskies tonight. You see right there the good defense, help side, weak side help defense by the Huskies, and then they're at their best running the floor. The little dip and under for Tarazi. See her smooth in the court, and there's Svetlana Abrosimova leading the way, 19 points.
Yeah, 15 turnovers for Washington in that first half. So the Huskies of UConn had a 19-point score. The Huskies of Washington had a 19-point score as well. Kelly O'Neal played the half of her young career so far.
Well, her previous career high was 16 points. She's got more than that, 19 at the half, so she's been hot tonight. The lone bright spot for the Huskies today. There you see the good ball movement. She steps out and she drills it from behind the line. Good half of basketball for Kelly O'Neal, not intimidated at all by the number one ranked team in the nation. In her gym tonight, the new Bank of America Arena.
8 of 11 in the first half was O'Neal. Unfortunately, the rest of the Washington scorers, not here. Barbie is here tonight. How about that? UConn 53, Washington 27. Second half is coming up. 53-27, UConn on top. And we're underway, second half. Washington to inbound. Sarah Duncan gets the start here in the second half. And Franja, it's been a long night for her. 1 of 10 from the field. Misses that shot. Abrosimova, along with Sue Bird, Shea Ralph, Asia Jones, and Swin Cash. Backdoor Ralph. She's got 9.
They take what the defense gives them. Megan Franza overplaying Shea Ralph out on the wing, and Shea Ralph just burns her back door.
Mendiola. And the youngster misses. She makes that one. The question is, will they count it? Nope. They wipe it off.
It's a good job, Mendiola, being aggressive. She gets after it defensively, picks up the loose ball, and then takes it right to the chest and the body, knocks down Swin Cash, but it's a good job taking the charge, and Mendiola, no basket.
Ralph trying to post up against the young freshman. And actually, Ralph is going to get the foul. Third personal on Shea Ralph. If you're looking for an upset, you're in the wrong spot. I think UConn has brought the A game here. They did not play well. UConn didn't in the first 5 minutes of this ball game, but still they built a 15-point lead in those first 5 minutes. Sheets with a shot that's blocked. Franza gets that one.
Megan Franza has struggled tonight. She's been pressing. She knows that Lori Payne is not out there, their other scoring. She's got to pick up the bulk of the scoring, and she's just been pressing. That was a good job on the other end, though, taking it to the hoop. A couple dribbles, pulling up. That's a good move for her.
Duncan getting set to shoot, and a whistle in low. Asia Jones with the foul for UConn.
You see it went in and out, and that's the key to breaking a defense. Make them move. Megan Franza with the up move, couple dribbles, pulls up in the key. That's a good move.
Duncan with the miss. This is Bird. In low to Jones. O'Neal wants the ball in low. Franza heaves up a three. O'Neal gets it back. Sheets, Mendiola. That's her first bucket of the night. And an offensive foul against UConn.
Called this game pretty tight, and the fact that they're calling the hand check, they've called the incidental contact down low so far this game. It takes some getting used to at the beginning of the season when the refs, they want to do their job. I mean, that's barely any contact right there. Technically, it's a foul, but later on in the year, in the tournament, you're not going to see those type of calls.
Sarah Duncan. Franza with a quick trigger. Sheets with some hard work. Washington with a second chance. Franza got that one. She's got six. You know, Washington has a nice little run here to start the second half. They brought this thing back within 22.
Well, you've noticed in both the possessions that they've scored, they have taken their time, worked the ball inside and out, and made the Connecticut defense move. I mean, when you just stand there and toss up three-pointers, it doesn't take much defense. You're not likely to make it. You know, most teams shoot 35% from the three-point line. The key is to work the ball around, get a wide-open three if that's what you're looking for, or take a couple dribbles and drive the basket. Look, the up fake right there. She gets Swincash on her heels, and then she's got enough room to pull up for the jumper. And that is much, it's an easier shot. It's a closer shot. It's a higher percentage shot than a three.
Up Rosamova. With that bucket, now with 21. Mendiola stumbled, and Sue Bird has a layup and missed it. She was the point guard of the year last year. She won the Nancy Lieberman Klein Award, and she's human. She missed the layup.
Well, it's always that thing when you get the ball wide open in the court and you're the only one out there. You think it's so easy and your mind goes 100 miles an hour. I got to make this. I got to make this. Should I go left hand? Should I go right hand? And then all of a sudden you're underneath the hoop and you brick it. Most embarrassing thing that can happen.
You never miss layups. Come on.
I've been right here before. Ah, easy too. I'll use the left. Oh, no.
One thing that UConn has had all night long is the back door.
That's just beautiful execution. They spread the court, get up 1-4 high. That's their natural offensive set. And then Shea Ralph reads the D, just takes Franz a back door. That's your first option in a 1-4 high. Get it to the high post, swing the wing through, see if you can get them the ball. If not, they can always come back out. But in that instance right there, it's textbook basketball back door. And the Huskies do not recover, and there's no weak side help in a 1-4 set.
Washington will hold on to the possession. Huskies lost in overtime at Indiana in a game in which they tied on a three-point shot to get to overtime and then lost on a three-point shot at the end of overtime and then beat Michigan on that same road trip. Michigan had just beaten Louisiana Tech, a top 20 team. But here tonight, it's been all UConn, O'Neal, Bird, Taurasi, to Ralph, Taurasi for three, bang, boy. I think you're going to be hearing her name for the next 4 years an awful lot, Diana Taurasi.
She's just smooth. She has that quality about her where you know something good will happen with the ball in her hand. She's 6 feet tall and she's a point guard. She has that vision. She can see over the top of the defenders and she's quick. I mean, she has every quality you need in a point guard.
And she's got 8 points. UConn is good. And they're showing it, 60-33. On number one in the country, 60-33 over Washington. 4.5 minutes into this second half. Saturday at 12:30, don't miss a Big 12 rivalry. Number one, Oklahoma. And Bob Simmons' swan song at Oklahoma State. Obvious BCS implications for Rick Neuheisel and the Huskies. College football Saturday, 12:30. On Fox Sports Net. No BCS involved in women's college basketball. UConn is number one. Mr. Tuiasa Sopo. Hoping that Boston College has some success tomorrow.
And did you see who was sitting behind him? Brock Huard. Getting ready for the Denver Broncos on Sunday. Those are two pretty good athletes. What do you think?
Not bad.
Those two are good friends, though. When Marcus backed him up, he always had a good job. He took it humbly when Brock was the starter and looked and just waited his turn.
Sue Bird with a three. And of course, Huard has some ties to this University of Washington women's program.
Well, Brock was married to former Husky Molly Hills, now obviously Molly Huard, and actually I've heard that Marcus is dating Megan Tranza.
Oh, really?
So maybe another connection there, football and basketball.
Bird. And she'll go to the line. Sarah Duncan picks up the foul for Washington. Well, it'll be interesting to see what the direction of both the men's and the women's programs here at Washington with this facility now. Jim Doherty talked today about the recruiting benefits of bringing a recruit into this facility now. It used to be that she'd bring them on campus and show them a model. She said it's much better to bring them into the real thing than show them the model.
Well, I know, as I mentioned before, that when I was getting recruited, they showed me the plans. That was clear back in 1992. So this has been in the works for a long time, and it's has to be such a fulfilling feeling right now. It's like a dream finally becomes reality when you look at those prints and you sell those prints, as June Doherty has to so many recruits, that it's nice to actually, you can bring the recruit in and have her look at the gym. As for Bob Bender's team as well, finally, not that Heck Edmondson was a recruiting, that it didn't hurt them, but it just didn't help them. And this facility is magnificent, one of the best on the West Coast.
Lalum driving off to Pimley. Washington with a small lineup out there right now. Erickson the miss and a whistle. One of the big differences, if you've been to games or watch games in Heck Ed, one of the big differences in this facility is the pitch of the seats on the baseline. Look how close the seats are on the baseline. And in Heck Ed, the slope was very gradual. And coaches talked about you kind of lose that home court edge because the seats aren't right up on the baseline.
Well, I think the biggest difference in this arena is that it's closed in. Before, there was the open grandstands where they would move the bleachers in on one side. And that made all the difference in the world, where you could see for miles and it seemed like such a huge gym. It seemed like you were almost in a football field because there was so much room in this gym and the ceiling was so high. And now it's closed in, it has a very cozy feeling. It feels much smaller, although they expanded the seating to fit 10,000.
Obrozhimova now with what seems like 10,000 points. She's got 23 and she almost forced a turnover. Yeah, about 10,000 in the seating here.
So they increased the seating by 2,100 people, yet it feels smaller. It feels more intimate, and it's definitely going to be louder.
And what they did basically is take the playing surface, or the court itself, and shift it about 30 to 40 feet towards Montlake, towards the streets, and away from the water. And that brought it closer to those seats in the baseline. And then obviously they put seats. There's a practice facility upstairs on the end zone you're looking at right now. You go up to that second level behind those seats. There's a huge practice facility right behind there. The basketball offices are being moved in here. There's a Hall of Fame that's ready to open in a couple of weeks.
The practice facility will be so nice because when volleyball is in season and men's and women's basketball, you have to share the gym time. And sometimes you'd be practicing 6 a.m. to be able to get in the gym. So I know the players are going to be excited about the fact that there will now be three gyms available. They can all practice at the same time.
Can Rita Johnson with a three-pointer. Mendiola misses a three. And here comes Taurasi. Offensive foul.
Well, Jill Pimley has already taken one charge tonight. That is her specialty. She's not a legitimate scoring threat. She'll score when given the opportunity. Her job out there is to hustle, to take charges, to play defense, and to lead this team to distribute the ball offensively. And that's already two charges tonight. And that's what she does best. She says in the media guide, what does she do better than anybody? She can flop. She knows how to draw a charge. A little bit of drama.
The University of Washington men tomorrow against New Mexico State in this facility, a 2 o'clock start. And a foul by Ralph. I think it's going to be her fourth personal. But the Washington men and the Washington women last year having to play off campus. And it was really a down year for both programs.
It's so difficult to build the emotion that you need for a home court advantage when the gym is half empty. And Key Arena for them was half empty, and it just, you can't get the feel of the crowd getting into it, and it's just very difficult. Plus, last year was a down year for both teams. They didn't produce the kind of success they wanted, and whether it's because of the gym or because of the players, that's what is hard to figure out. But it will be much easier to generate excitement for the program when you're on your campus. You're not bussed off to your own home court.
Well, Bob Bender has already had one of the best recruiting classes in the country and the kids that he signed early. June Doherty feels it's having an impact on her recruiting as well. Tamika Williams with that bucket. UConn has stretched this lead now on a 17-0 run. O'Neal.
Well, that's what you have to do. It's Kelly O'Neal, and you know she's going to come through. She's definitely been the go-to player tonight for the Huskies. Really the only one in rhythm tonight, and she's playing well offensively.
Her first 2 points of the second half, 21 in the ball game. And Williams goes right by Erickson.
Just look at the speed of the Connecticut interior. They're not a big interior team. Kelly Schumacher, 6'5", on the bench with a stress fracture. So right now, their center and power forward are only 6'2", which is not big, but they are extremely quick.
Mendiola back out to O'Neal. And here comes Byrd. Good ball movement, Johnson for three.
A beautiful pass.
Ashley Battle with the bucket.
That right there is why Sue Bird is considered the best point guard in the nation, or one of the very elite in the nation. You see the loose ball, boom, eyes in the back of her head, sees her cutting teammate on a dime with the little bounce pass. That's just good ball movement, and that was not Sue Bird. That was Morgan Valley, the freshman. They just come at you. There's so many of them, you just can't.
Bird had a good pass to start the sequence. So if this were hockey, she would get an assist.
She'd probably like that. Build her stats a little bit. Pump them up. She doesn't need to pump anymore.
You know, in the Final Four last year, in the semifinal of the championship game, she had 9 assists and no turnovers. 77-35. And we're not halfway through this second half. Stick around. Bank of America Arena. A good look at it. Much like Key Arena in a sense, it's built as a basketball facility, and so the seats are right up on the floor.
The seats are actually closer than Key Arena because there's no hockey facility here, so they're just a slight bit closer, but the fans appreciate it, I'm sure.
Yeah, 10,000 seats. And a lot of them filled tonight, a good-sized crowd on hand. I'm guessing about 7 to 8 for this one. Baseline jumper from Heather Reichman. And she misses and everybody goes down. That's why you wear a mouthpiece.
Wearing a mouthpiece is, some players like it. I always hated it because you can't breathe as well. Your mouth gets really dry, and but you want that insurance. The last thing you want to do is look like a hockey player with all your teeth missing.
Mendiola's headed out because there's some blood on her mouthpiece. And obviously she's on her way out to get that taken care of. And she fouled out as well. So that's a little injury to the insults. But as a true freshman, Washington very, very high on her. She had 15 at Indiana. She nearly had a double-double at Michigan, 10 points and 8 rebounds.
She was the one at Indiana that hit the three-pointer to send it into overtime. It was a desperation shot that found nothing but the net.
The Washington coaches, June Doherty right now is at the scorer's table. I think they had a question. I didn't have Mendiola with 4 fouls. That was a surprise to me, and I think it's a surprise to the Washington coaches as well. They checked the books. And she does indeed have 5 fouls.
Disappointed for Mendiola's family, who has come all the way up from California. Her and her sister, obviously teammates on this Washington team. 1-1, ladies. She's one of 9 children in the Mendiola family. 5 brothers, 3 sisters, and her sister is not her twin sister. She's a year older, and she waited for her sister to come play. So they both entered the UW as freshmen. Her sister on the court right now.
There they are.
And that's the clan.
The Mendiola brothers, Mendiola father.
Very athletic background. Her mom actually was on the Peru national team for basketball. And her dad played semi-pro soccer, and her brothers were also good athletes in high school from down there in California.
Yep, 9 kids total. Edgardo, the father, was the pro soccer player.
They needed just one more, and they'd have 2 teams,
I
2
know.
Basketball teams.
Alicia was the guard. She played on a team in Peru that was the Peruvian national champs. You saw their jerseys. They've got those white jerseys, the 13 and the 31. Well, when mom was the great star in Peru, she wore 13. And when the girls got to high school and played on the same team, they battled over who would wear number 13. So they played a game of 1-on-1, and the winner got 13. And the winner
was the younger sister.
The younger one.
Juliana.
So the older one said, all right, I'll take 31.
I'm sure the older sister had to eat a little crow on that one. But Gioconda waited for her sister. And it says how strong their family ties are. She had other scholarship offers from other universities, but she wanted to wait so she could play with her sister.
Count the bucket, an athletic move by Kenrita Johnson. And there's the older sister by a year, but they're both freshmen. El Toro High School. Out in Orange County. Johnson the miss, and here comes Gioconda. Mendiola. O'Neal working on a big night continues. 23 now for Kelly O'Neal, who'll be joined by her younger sister next year. Kristen is signed, and she'll be a Husky next year. That's some sweet stuff from Asia Jones.
Two back-to-back turnaround jumpers, from one from O'Neal and one from Jones. And that's just pretty basketball. You can't stop a fadeaway jumper.
Baseline jumper is good from Heather Reichman. Her first bucket of the ball game. Reichman, a local kid from Seattle. 40-point ball game. Bird. UConn is very deep, and you know, at some point you're asking yourself, when is Geno going to call off the dogs, so to speak? Well, the problem is, everybody in that, just about everybody, is a parade All-American in high school. They're very, very deep in terms of rotation anyways. So everybody that's playing are almost like a first unit anyways.
Well, honestly, for Connecticut, their most challenging opponent for much of the season is themselves in practice. When they go against each other, that's where there's so many parade All-Americans and so much talent and so much depth, they can't all play at the same time. And so when they're going at each other in practice, that's when the coaching staff said they see some of their most competitiveness come out, is during practice.
Mendiola, Gioconda with the turnover. Cheryl Sorensen into the Washington lineup. And Gioconda Mendiola sits down. Here's O'Neal. Franza walked with the ball. And it's a Washington turnover.
There's not a lot of rhythm right now to the Husky offense, the Washington Husky offense. They need to take their time and move the ball, but they have to move with a purpose. Kick it inside. Make the defense shift down. Make them drop down to cover the post. Kick it out for the three. But right now, their passes are just going all the way around the outside of the three-point line. They're not penetrating the defense.
Asia Jones. Me and Mrs. Jones. 11 now for Asia Jones. 84-41. UConn, in their first two wins, has hit 99 and 98 points. And with plenty of time here to shoot for the 100 mark, they're well on their way to getting it. Johnson, in low to Swin Cash. Valid. Me and Mrs. Jones.
We She's got a feeling thing. It now.
We got a thing. She's got 13 now.
It's always fun when you get in that zone and you look at the shooter's eyes and they kind of bob their head a little bit. They're a little bit confident. They know they're on a roll.
Asia Jones at UConn, certainly. 86-41.
You can celebrate the legendary
86-41. 7:42 left. Ball game. UConn is number one, and boy, don't they look like it tonight.
Well, if there's any doubt before, I don't think there is now.
Whistle inside. Jumper from Morgan Valley. And the foul on Cheryl Sorensen of Washington. This one got away early. Gino Auriemma said today that he wanted UConn to be able to push the tempo and play their style of basketball. And boy, have they. He's not a, REM isn't a guy that worries a whole lot about at this stage of the season against an opponent like Washington. It's more along the lines of just worry about yourself than worry about a team you haven't seen.
He's a three-time National Coach of the Year. And you can see the improvement in players when they start there and 4 years later, what him and his staff does with that program. And there's also been, his staff has stayed together for a long period of time. All of his assistants have been there for long periods of time. Chris Daly came in with him 16 years ago. They've been in this, you know, together in this program. And that kind of longevity just breeds success when there's not a lot of turnover.
Let's see if O'Neal can increase her scoring. She does. Well, Kelly O'Neal's got 25 right now. She had 19 in the first half. Taurasi, good-looking freshman. And here comes Washington. UConn continues to push the pace. Valley misses with the left hand. Reichman. And it's a UConn ball, and both teams will go to their bench. Franza sits down, Reichman sits down, Sorensen sits down for Washington. Asia Jones gets a chance to rest. Marcy Zell in the ball game for UConn. Along with Kenitra Johnson.
For the Huskies, I think the thing they need to concentrate on with this loss is not to become frustrated. They are playing the best team in the nation in UConn, and they are 40 points down, and why that's disheartening now.
Kelly O'Neal's got 27.
They can't worry so much about the final margin at this point. They have to continue to play hard and realize, hey, that's where you have to be. If you want to play for a national championship, this is where you have to be. This is the work you have to put in. And these are the things you have to try to accomplish. This is the cream of the crop. So it gives them a good indication of where they need to be.
Morgan Valley with her first 2 points. Well, it's a Washington team that is trying to rebound from last year. They had a great win at Michigan and a close call at Indiana to start the season. And a good runner from Ashley Battle.
Well, this Washington team will be improved over last year. They had just 8 wins last year. They had a lot of injuries to their front line. They didn't have a lot of depth there. O'Neal was hurt. Leanne Sheets missed some time with an ankle surgery. They were battling injuries. They did not have a senior on their roster last year. And right now, they're one of their best players, definitely their best pure shooter on the bench, Lori Payne. And you can see she's frustrated. She's not out there. She wanted to play this game. I talked to her weeks before the season started, and she was excited about this game already, opening the new arena, playing against these girls that she played with this summer on the Jones team when she was in Taiwan. They won the gold medal. She roomed with Shea Ralph. You know, you get to be friends with some of these players, and it's nice when you're friends, but also you can go out there and have good competition. And so one of their best players on the bench, but they will be an improved team this season.
Four and a half minutes left in this ball game. UConn out of the Big East Conference. And that has become quite a basketball conference for the women. Obviously, for the men, it had that great run in the 80s.
Well, Notre Dame today got another big win over Georgia, 75-73. And they have one of the best players in the country as well, Ruth Riley, for the Notre Dame Irish. A lot of talent in the Big East.
Sarah Duncan hits a three. Rutgers is a top 10 team out of the Big East. Boston College. And obviously you've got UConn and Notre Dame. Taurasi.
When you talk about UConn's execution, perfect example. Morgan Valley, the eyes up. She reads Taurasi, just taking around back door, the quick cut and the nice catch and the reverse underneath. That's smooth.
There's Christine Rigby, the senior out of Victoria, British Columbia. So this is sort of a homecoming for her. And she checks in the ball game. UConn closing in on 100. 3:47 left at Bank of America Arena. 96-49, 3:47 left in the second half. UConn cruising, to put it lightly. Washington will go to 1-2. UConn will go to 3-0.
Well, I was talking to Sarah Duncan, one of the guards on the Washington team, and asking her what the team did for Thanksgiving dinner yesterday, and they all went over to her house, and her mom made two turkeys and a ham, 15 pounds of potatoes. And I said, well, are you going to blame your mom if you guys don't play well tonight? She's like, no, I can't put that kind of pressure on my mom. But I guess the UConn team went to dinner at a nice place down on the water, and they said they had a nice Thanksgiving dinner. And at this point in college, it's almost being like with your family when you're with your team. You're that close.
Gino Auriemma had a lot of nice things to say about Seattle. He said his team has had a great time in town. Of course, they started this West Coast trip at Pepperdine in Malibu, one of the most beautiful campuses in all the country. Loose ball foul.
Different types of beauty between Pepperdine and the University of Washington, but both definitely have their upsides.
Women's college basketball around the nation today. UConn, of course, talk about 22nd consecutive week at number one. Georgia lost to UConn early, and today, as you noted, Notre Dame beat Georgia. Oregon and Stanford. Oregon has catapulted themselves up to number 14 with wins over Wisconsin and North Carolina State, both top 20 teams.
Which is impressive because they lost their best player and their starting point guard before the season started, Shaquayla Williams, out for the season with a knee injury, and that really hurt their strength coming back in. They're a senior-dominated team without their point guard, who is only a junior. She will miss this season, though, redshirt, to repair that knee and be back next season. But quite a blow to the Ducks' hope for national prominence. And as you can see, that program, Jody Runge, an excellent coach down there in Eugene, Oregon, and getting it done again.
One area where the Pac-10 needs to improve is in the NCAA tournament. They have not had a lot of success in the NCAA tournament the last few years.
Well, I think since Stanford went in 1997 to the Final Four with Kate Starbird's class, I don't think there's been a Pac-10 team back to the Final Four. And there's none forecasted to go this year either.
Marcy Zell with her first bucket. And the last non-Stanford team out of the Pac-10 to get to the Final Four is what, a USC team in the mid-80s, early 80s?
I think you'd have to go that far back. Washington made it to the Elite Eight in 91, but did not make it to the Final Four. And before that, it's the SC teams, obviously back in the national championship days with Cheryl Miller and Cynthia Cooper and that crew.
UCLA has had some nice teams as of late, but has been unable to get to the Final Four. Arizona, Joan Bombassini has seen a Sweet 16.
Well, UCLA last year was picked in the top 10 to start the season, but never just quite got in that rhythm that they needed. An offensive dominated team, and I think defensively we're not able to turn the corner, and defense wins championships. And I know coaches say that, and it's a cliche, but it's the truth. UCLA could score with anybody. They just couldn't stop anybody either.
Not like their football team. Taurasi.
That's exactly right.
With 14 now as she puts UConn at an even 100. There's a three from Emily Autry. Another sophomore that Washington is depending on. She's in that starting five. She did not play well early on tonight.
Well, they're expecting big things out of Autry. Most athletic player on the team. She's got good hops. She moves well without the basketball. She's good on the baseline. She's consistent with the baseline jumper. And they need her to step up in a big way to man that three spot this year.
Under a minute left. UConn, the last team to score 100 against University of Washington was UConn.
That was actually back in Connecticut a few years ago when Jamie Redd and Amber Hall and that group was made the trip back to Connecticut.
Boy, that's a long trip and then you give up 101 points. Wallum has the miss. And the foul by Zell. As I mentioned, UConn gets right into the Big East coming up as they start with Miami on the road on December 5th. They've got, along with the Big East schedule, which is a pretty darn good one, they play at Louisiana Tech. They have home and home with Tennessee. A road game at Illinois on the top 20 team. But they're off to a great start.
Well, they need a challenging schedule. With the kind of plans that they have of winning a national championship, you want those challenging games as a player and as a coach. You want to see how good you can be. That's the only way you can truly improve, is if you see what your weaknesses are. And that's how you do it, is against great competition that pushes you to your limit.
Ball game over, but it was over a long, long time ago. Gina Auriemma and his UConn Huskies, number one in the country, showed it tonight. The story for Washington, they open Bank of America Arena. A $40 million renovation to this 72-year-old building, and it feels brand new. UConn wins it 100-54. For Elise Woodward, I'm Rich Waltz. Bank of America Arena is open for business. Make sure you tune in Wednesday night, December 6th, when Washington hosts